I've received a number of follow-up questions about the H and the L settings on the camera. I'm going to cover that now. Hi everyone, welcome to Pal to Tech. On the Fujifilm X-T3 and X-T4 cameras, the camera's base ISO is 160. Any native ISO above the base ISO of 160 is acquired by amplification of the electrical voltage hitting the sensor's photosites. Now, both the L and the H settings on the dial don't work that way. Instead, they apply what are called extended ISO ranges. This means that when you use the L or the H settings, ISO is applied through the camera's software instead, like the exposure slider in Lightroom or Photoshop, and simply crank up the brightness of the image after it's already been processed by the camera's analog to digital converter. Let's talk about the L dial. This is by far the most confusing one, and it's what I get the most questions about. On the X-T3 and the X-T4, the camera allows you to assign either 80, 100, or 125 to the L ISO setting. Here's the cause of all the confusion. If the camera's lowest native ISO is 160, you know, the lowest number that you set on the dial, then that's the point at which little or no electrical amplification is applied to the sensor's photosites. It's the lowest base ISO. When you're shooting at L, and say you have it set to 80, you are really exposing the camera at ISO 160, and this is actually overexposing your image by one stop. Then, the camera is bringing down the overexposure stop using its built-in software before generating the JPEG or the RAW file. So, setting the ISO dial to L, you know, which you've configured to 80, is exactly the same thing as shooting at ISO 160, but with a one-stop increase of exposure compensation. The camera shoots the image overexposed, and then it develops it underexposed. This also results in the appearance of one stop less dynamic range. And this could blow out some of your highlights depending upon what you're shooting and whether or not your camera is in one of its auto exposure settings. The photo on the left is 160, the photo on the right is 80. Look at how you can see a bit more highlight detail in the one shot at 160 than the one shot at 180. Have a look at this area just right here versus right here. The one that was shot in ISO 80 kind of blew out the highlights. However, if you look at the shadow areas, kind of adds a little punch to the scene, maybe, you know? Remember, these two photos were shot when the camera was in auto exposure mode. I was not setting the aperture or the shutter speed manually. I had the camera on a tripod and I had a custom white balance set for both photos. If you're gonna use L at 80, then I would not use it in any of the camera's auto exposure modes. Instead, set everything to manual on the camera and put your ISO at 160. Then, expose for the highlights of the scene. Then once you've done that, turn the ISO dial to L at 80, right? And then take your shot. Let me show you what I did here. I did exactly that in these pictures. Both pictures were shot exactly with the same manual settings on the camera. The only difference between the two of them is that on one shot, it had an ISO of 160. The other shot has an ISO of 80. Look at the window detail here. You see how it's just a little bit better in the shot that's at 80. It kind of, you know, brings a little more detail in those highlights out. You see that? And that's the exact opposite behavior of what would have happened had I had the camera been in all auto everything and done this same thing. But by putting the camera in manual, I take more control over the camera, and then when I dial it down to L as my last step before I take the shot, this is what I get. And then in the kind of the shadowy area, here's the one on the left, it adds a little bit more silhouette-y look to it. Look at the hand of the skeleton here versus the hand of the skeleton here in the one shot with 80. I have a lot of skeletons in my garage, just saying. So Anyway, ISO continues to be a very confusing subject, but hopefully this video has helped you to understand how the L dial factors into all of this. If you did think that the video was helpful, please give it the like and subscribe, and I will see you again in a video real soon. Take care.